Danas smo na Fakultetu sporta I fizičkog vaspitanja ovde u Novom Sadu. Prvi put imamo priliku da organizujemo doktorsku školu, međunarodnu doktorsku školu iz oblasti zdravlja I sportskih nauka. I zapravo ovom prilikom smo prvi put pokušali da internacionalizujemo tu školu. Sva predavanja će biti na engleskom jeziku od strane gostiju koji dolaze iz različitih zemalja širom sveta. I ne samo što ćemo imati priliku da ugostimo sjajne predavače, nego će biti naši polaznici I studenti našeg fakulteta, odnosno Univerziteta u Novom Sadu, ali takođe Univerziteta u Splitu, Univerziteta u Zagrebu I Univerziteta u Pečuju, a možda još I neko drugi. Tu su naši gosti iz Mađarske, profesor Jožef Betlehem sa Fakulteta sportskih nauka, tu je profesor iz Amerike koji je trenutno izvan, profesor Jay Hoffman, naš stari prijatelj, takođe profesor Antonino Bianco sa Univerziteta u Palermu iz Italije I naša profesorka Ivana Milovarović, na koju smo posebno ponosni, jedan sjajni mladi sociolog, profesorka koja će takođe govoriti našim studentima. U suštini mi pokušamo već godinama da ovaj fakultet podignemo iznad jednog nivoa koji je ranije bio sa željom da naši studenti dobiju najbolja, najnovija znanja, da nauče, naroče naši studenti doktorskih studija, da nauče kako se strukturišu istraživanja, kako se pišu najbolji radovi, kako se organizuje savremena nauka u oblasti onoga čime se mi bavimo, to je sportska nauka I jedan deo biomedicinskih nauka koja pripada našoj oblasti. Tako da je cilj zapravo da napravimo jednu međunarodnu mrežu koja će podržavati sve istraživačke aktivnosti mladih ljudi. Mi smo kao fakultet među najuglednijim fakultetima na univerzitetu u Novom Sadu kada je reč o naučnoj produkciji. Personalno imamo I nekoliko izuzetno jakih, dobrih, kvalitetnih profesora I istraživača. Želimo da naši studenti budu još bolji od nas. Tako da je ovo jedna od inicijativa, prvi put je organizujemo, planiramo da svake godine imamo jednu na jesen, jednu na proleće I veoma se radujem da u narednom navratu ponovo pozovemo neke dobre, interesantne predavače, a takođe I da vidimo vas ovde koji ste nas do sada uvek verno pratili.
If we are talking about the health of the general population and about the individual health, then we can see great disparities. And in order to tackle that kind of disparities in the society, you have to find the common language. And this common language can rely on the literacy, and especially on health literacy. So I think if we would make more people aware of health literacy, we could get we could improve the health level of the population as well. And in order to find different interventions and techniques, we also need some kind of research. Just research is one way how we can tackle that kind of problem. And if we collect the best practices regionally and internationally, probably more and more people can find the appropriate way how they can improve their health. And health literacy, so how they interpret their health, what kind of health habits they would like to shape, and what kind of health behavior they would like to follow, are those questions what we have to tackle.
We're just comparing different modalities of recovery to resistance training in experienced resistance trained individuals. The goal is to get them to think about the science behind it and to use this as motivation to think of other studies that they can do to examine this. Since they were doctoral students, it's to provide food for thought of how maybe they can redo the study, maybe looking at a different angle, and taking it one step further, looking at different types of combinations. I think that's science. It's rarely do you get a yes-no response to any question that you have in science. Generally, it's what's the situation, who's the individual, and I think that's the kind of the take-home message. It's not simple. It's not like a car that you turn on the engine and it works. You know, with a human being, the physiology for everybody is slightly different, and how somebody responds to a particular stimulus can be quite different than the person right next to them. As a sports scientist, you need to know the physiology of how everything would work, and then you'd be able to find. You have more tools in your tool belt that you can utilize at specific times. So you have an idea of what the science says, and then the practical use of that, you have many experiences that you can use at that point. And I think students learned something today about how we did the science, but how we use that science practically in several experiences that I've had over my career.
The main idea of my lecture was to share the experience about one systematic review related to counter movement jump test. We carried out a systematic search and we discovered what are the best procedures that can be shared in order to avoid mistakes and to assess athletes and young adolescents in a nice way. It's interesting to share with the PhD students this concept because we systematically show what all processes. So in our opinion, it's interesting to see what are the stages of scientific publications, and at the end of the day, we have a successful paper and publish it in IPA Factory Journal. It is important because they can face the reality, they can face the process, and to understand, as I was telling during the lesson, was just one idea, one curiosity that comes during one journal club from Luca Petrigna, that is a PhD student, that was curious to understand why there are a lot of methodology and why we are not able to detect a common procedure. That's why we started to search, we find a gap in the scientific literature, we try to publish it to update in this field of research the knowledge, and finally we get the results. Students, according to this experience, they can transfer this experience in each kind of sports. And for example, Serbia is a sport-oriented country because you have a successful rate of medal, and also in the team sport you are good as a nation, so you can transfer this kind of knowledge, scientific knowledge, to the sport field. And each single coach, if it is driven by and managed by Novi Sad School of Physical Education and Sport and this kind of doctoral school, can get benefits from scientific knowledge, because the scientific knowledge help coaches and professionals to train better to reduce the risk of injury. In this case, we were focusing in public health context, but the principle and the mechanism are the same.
Ja ću danas govoriti o mogućnostima osnaživanja osjetljivih društvenih grupa kroz sport, zato što je istraživački tim našeg fakulteta kroz realizaciju jednog velikog evropskog projekta koji se zove Sportom protiv nasilja i društvene isključenosti detektovao problem vršnjačkog nasilja i šire socijalne isključenosti dece u dečjem i omladinskom sportu generalno. Tako da ću ovom prilikom studentima doktorskih studija predstaviti sa teorijskog aspekta koncept socijalne isključenosti, socijalne uključenosti nasuprot njega u čitavom društvu i u sportu kao jednom vrlo, vrlo specifičnom društvenom fenomenu i polju. Tako da ću ovom prilikom dvostruku negde ulogu imati kroz prezentaciju doprinosa teoretičara na polju socijalne isključenosti u sportu i kroz prezentaciju rezultata terenskih istraživanja koje smo mi realizacijom SAVE projekta, do kojih smo realizacijom SAVE projekta zapravo i došli. Lično, s obzirom na to da sam profesorka sociologije sporta, ovo istraživanje smatram veoma važnim za studente fakulteta sporta i fizičkog vaspitanja generalno, samim tim i za doktorante kao naše istraživače, zato što je potrebno sagledati društvene komponente sporta, društvenu prirodu sporta, jer je sport jedan toliko kompleksan društveni fenomen koji ne pripada samo sportskoj nauci, on ne pripada samo medicini, on ne pripada samo pedagogiji ili psihologiji, već i sociologiji, i pravnoj nauci, i ekonomskoj nauci i mnogim drugim naukama, i kao takav je jedinstven u čitavom društvu. I potrebno je da naši doktoranti prisutni na ovoj doktorskoj školi sagledaju tu društvenu prirodu sporta i u okviru nje, koja je vrlo kompleksna, jedan specifičan deo, a to je društvena isključenost i nasuprot nje društvena uključenost, odnosno socijalna inkluzija naročito osjetljivih društvenih grupa kroz sport.
I'm Zoltán Alföldi from Hungary, University of Pécs, Health Sciences Doctoral School. And the first point I love Serbia. That's why every time when I have a chance, I came here. I love Subotica, Novi Sad, Belgrade. Every year I came and visit all cities. First time I'm a rowing coach in Hungary. That's why before the session I went to the Reka Danubius and checked the rowing coaches. And these lectures, Mr. J, from come to the sport, that's why the big interest for me. And in Hungary, with my team, we use cold therapy. And Mr. Ostojic, the famous person about the hydrogen, that's why we would like to test our athletes and new investigation. I would like to come more time here in Novi Sad because very developed this university. That's why I wanted to come here and check this.
I am Pascal Uchechikuokwe from the University of Pech, Doctoral School of Health Sciences. But I'm an Nigerian and I'm studying integrated healthcare system. This is my dissertation topic in the University of Pech. So I was very interested to see what is happening because we did a lot of studies in my previous work as a health social worker, how the elderly can fall, safety falling. So I tend to see, let me see how I can be able to gain in one or two knowledge pertaining this particular lecture. That's of that of yesterday, so it's quite interesting and I really learned a lot from it.